His ex-colleague's scrutiny of this third beast, whom Jaymi introduces with as genial a breeze of small talk as when he introduced Evelyn, is filled first with quiet awe, and then with the gleam of a beady-eyed mission to reproduce Jaymi's breakthrough Shigem-creation, but repurposing him instead into an enhancement for Ain't They Freaky. Yes, the ugly ambition in Dud's face is clear. He would like nothing better than to incorporate a dumbed-down version of Shigem into his own tabloid product, so as to entertain customers of the Guy Score, Hunk or Gross newsfeed, no doubt setting up Bangdead's cartoony Shigem as a kind of reference target for a world full of Guy Scorers to mock and take aim at. While Dud contemplates all this commercial potential in Jaymi's beast, it's clear too that he's looking at him through the eyes and expectations of an average consumer of Ain't They Freaky. And as soon as Dud looks at him in this way, the main problem becomes apparent. Shigem is just too gay. To speak plain, as Dud so prides himself on doing, it'll need a bit of straightening out for normal people. Just as soon as Herb's team have worked out how he was created and have found a way to reverse engineer him, then that excessive gayness will be the first thing to fix. Jaymi pulls his own attention out of Dud and returns it to Shigem. Doing so, he is distraught to observe that Shigem's apprehension of the Bangdead duo's avid intentions is spreading through him like a seepage of pain. Although Shigem manages to maintain his external composure, the mere prospect of being repurposed comes at him like an assault, threatening not just to down-convert him into a form that feels cheaper, but to do violence to his own gay self and truth, to use his precious life for something other than he wants and needs.